Good morning. Welcome on my online class. For today, I would like to teach you narration in grammar items. Narration is very important and critical lesson for the students. Now, I would like to teach you narration. Most of the students are known to the term of narration. Okay, narration means speech. Narration means speech. It is of two kinds, direct narration and indirect narration. In direct narration, for direct narration, I can give an example of direct narration. He said to me, I am going to college. Then, if I would like to transform this sentence from direct to indirect, I have to, or you have to remember, or you have to memorize three things. You need at first to transform from direct to indirect. You have to do tense, sentence, person. If you have clear idea about tense, sentence and person, it will be better for understanding yourselves. Okay, I can present an example direct, and how to transform from direct to indirect, I am giving example. He said to me, I am going to college. There is given three topics. You have to remember three topics: tense, sentence, person. With the help of the term of tense, sentence and person, you have to complete this sentence from direct to indirect. He said to me, I am going to college. Then if I go to indirect, then you can see that he told me why. There is given, told. If the repeated speech, if the repeated speech is present continuous plus assertive sentence, so you have to take told. If the repeated speech is assertive sentence, you have to take told. Then object, and you can take, you have to take conjunction that for comma. And there is given in direct, I am going to college. I, first person. I have told you that you have to remember, you have to know tense, sentence and person. I, first person. If the person in repeated speech, if the subject is first person, it will be transformed into according to the subject of the repeating verb. I first person, and I stresses into the he. I goes to the he. He is subject of repeating verb, and this he will be said there after that he. And as the repeated speech or in red comma is present continuous tense, it will be transformed into past continuous tense. He was going to college. Now it will be very clear if I give some hints on direct. If there is two sentences, there is two part of direct. He said to me, and I am going to college. I am going to college is into inverted comma. If you see inverted comma, it will be, or it will be said repeated speech. And out of the inverted comma is called repeating verb and repeating speech. That means to sum up, I can say that out of inverted comma is called riveting verb and into the inverted comma is called riveted speech. Okay. Totally, I can say that those students have good idea or good command over tense, so it will be better for themselves. Because in inverted comma, if you see present indefinite tense, this sentence is maybe present indefinite tense, and you have to transform into past indefinite tense. If you can see any sentence in inverted comma present indefinite, according to indirect, while going to indirect, while transforming into indirect, you have to give past indefinite tense. You have to follow past indefinite tense. You have to use past indefinite tense. If you can see in inverted comma present continuous tense, you have to transform into past continuous tense into indirect time. Narration. Present perfect tense, past perfect tense. Like this. Present perfect continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense. Okay. I can give you again some hints. Direct narration, there is two part. Repeated speech and repeating verb. Repeated speech is called the inverted comma into the inverted comma, and repeating verb is out of inverted comma. And if in repeated speech the sentence is present indefinite tense, you have to transform into past indefinite tense while transforming from direct to indirect. If repeated speech is in the form of present continuous tense, you have to transform into past continuous tense. Like this, if the inverted sentence is in the form of present perfect, you have to transform into this sentence past perfect tense. Present perfect continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense. Totally. And like this, you have to transform direct to indirect following these rules and regulations of narration. There are many rules and regulations of transforming direct to indirect in narrative style. But for today, I can present these sentence rules and regulations of narration. Okay, for today, dear students, you have to listen. For today, you have to practice these rules and regulations. Okay, for today, thank you again. Online class, welcome. Be safe. Okay.